There it is. Notice the past tense. Ephesians 1:3, blessed be the God of the Father, of the Lord Jesus Christ, who hath blessed us with every spiritual gift or spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Notice the past tense, has blessed us. In other words, you are wondrously and continuously supplied with blessings. In other words, all that you will ever need to reach the end of your days on earth, faithful to the Lord Jesus Christ, has already been given to you by the grace of God. But there's another dimension to this word grace. It can also speak of specific help. Somebody shout help. Supplied to us at a time of need. When we are called upon to stand for the Lord Jesus Christ in difficult times, or when it seems as if the devil is throwing everything he has against us, or when we feel that we are too weak or fearful to go on, or even all three, our God, the God of all grace, who supplies us with all the help we need, he gives us strength where strength is needed, or courage where courage is needed, or wisdom where wisdom is needed. As the writer of Hebrews has put it, when he too wrote to the sufferings of Christians in Hebrews chapter 4, verse 14 through 16, seeing then we have this great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast of our confession. For we do not have a high priest who cannot sympathize with our weaknesses, but was in all points tempted as we are, yet without sin. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help us in the time of need. Can I help somebody here on this afternoon? If it was strictly up to you and me and our own resources to stand faithful for Jesus Christ in these difficult times, we would never be able to do so. But we can do it with this assurance, because we have a God of all grace. We have a God that meets every need. We have a God that shows up right on time, and we can turn to him for everything we need. Can somebody in here look at your neighbor and you ought to shout the God of grace? Is there anybody here that have the declaration that I felt like giving up, but his grace? I felt like throwing in a towel, but his grace. Almost lost my mind, but his grace. Felt like having a breakdown, but his grace. It is the God of all grace that sustains us and that keeps us in the midst of every storm. And so every now and then, you ought to have a reflection and a flashback of the grace of God, that God saved you when you didn't deserve it, that God redeemed you when you were lost, that God found you where you were. Somebody ought to thank God that his grace is sufficient for me. Don't have food in my refrigerator, but I got his grace. Not driving the best car, but I got grace. Not having the best job that I want, but I got grace. Don't have a mansion on the top of a hill, but I got a grace. And every time you ought to walk around and people feel like you're defeated, you ought to look at them and tell them, I got grace, because his grace sustains me. His grace, I feel like preaching, his grace keeps me. His grace covers me. That's why I thank God for the old song that says how amazing grace it is. How sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost. Somebody ought to thank God for grace. I said, somebody ought to thank God for grace. I said, somebody ought to thank God for grace. If it wasn't for his grace, don't know where I will be. So I thank God for grace. And while he's giving me mercy, I thank him for his grace and mercy that brought me through. I'm living each moment because of you. I want to praise and thank because your grace and your mercy brought me through. Somebody ought to thank God for his grace. He's not, here it is, he's not a God of some grace. I'm saying like the old preachers used to say, I'm in the book. He's not the God of some grace. But say he the God of. Yeah, y'all should have got excited. Y'all should that was a shout right there. He doesn't just give me grace to make it to the next day. But he gives me grace to make it to the end. See, some of y'all treat God like a paycheck. I get paid every week or every 2 weeks. And so my praise is contingent. I only got enough praise and enough worship to the next week. But God don't operate like that. That's not how he blesses us. That's not how he gives us his grace. He doesn't just give us a grace, enough grace to make it to the next week. He gives us enough grace to make it to the end. And he says, I got so much grace in the hem of my garments that when you call on me, I show up. When you need me, I'll answer. That's why David said, you're a very present help in the time of trouble. Am I talking to anybody in the building that know him as present help? He's not only my strength for today, but he's my hope for tomorrow. He's not just the God of some grace, but the God of all grace. So that's who's doing the 100%. But second, we ought to look at the how of God's part. Ours is the God of all grace who calls us to his eternal glory by Christ Jesus. First, consider what it is that he has done for us. He called us. This is something that theologians often refer to as the effectual call of God. It's called effectual because it results in the one who is called actually coming to God in faith. When I was a little boy and it was getting late, you know, we would be outside and we'll be running around, and you knew when it was time to come in the house because the street lights. I know these young people, y'all don't know about, because this generation, they don't even go outside anymore. They sit at home, play the video games and all. Because I was just a disobedient child, I was downright just bad, and the street lights would come on, and I'm still outside playing around. And so my mom would call me. I ain't come. Get in. Let's go. Get in the house. I'm just annoying. I'm just keep on playing, you know. Acting like I don't hear. I hear very clearly because she got a big mouth, so I can hear. Called me the first time. I ain't coming to the house. It's time to come in the house for dinner. Come in the house. I'm still playing. Second time, Diane, come in the house. I'm just annoying it. I'm just still out there playing basketball, playing king ball, doing what I'm doing. All of a sudden, I get come out. I'm just playing the way I hear. It took her to put her hands on me. I need y'all to stay with me here. It took her to put her hands on me that actually brought me from where I was to where I was supposed to be. Can I help somebody here? Because of our disobedience, because God has called us time and time again, and we kept ignoring him because God has tried to tell us, you know, get over here, get saved. It's time for you to get right. It actually took the hand of God to snatch us from, where am I talking to anybody here? To snatch us from where we were to bring us. That's what God has done for us. Because we were falling in our nature. We were dead in sin. We could never have come to him in our own power. We had no power, but he took the initiative and issued an effectual call. He made us alive to him. And we came to him in faith. And the effectual call doesn't just stop at saving faith. It goes all the way to complete glorification in Christ Jesus.